morning.
Morning.
How's everybody doing today?
Good.
I wore my fall shirt. In honor of the holidays. Aren't you glad I wore this color? It should have been a dad. I'm full of dad jokes. All right. I'm on the platform, Jill Ponce. Thank you today, Amy, for these beautiful flowers. Very nice. Appreciate that.
Oh, okay.
Today we have Jennifer's back, Jennifer Sheets. And she's going to start with a song called Proud.
So you're going to get my alto two voice today. But please feel free to sing along if there's anything that you recognize and you feel inspired.
I just love starting with this song. It just makes me feel alive.
Look into the window of my mind. Reflections of the fears I know I left behind. I step out of the ordinary. I can feel my soul ascending. I'm on my
on my way, can't stop me.
So we're going to start today with, is this on?
Is this on?
Yes.
I should be really close.
Yes.
Okay.
We're going to start today with our vision statement. You ready? Say it with me.
A world of oneness where all people are free and encouraged to express their divine potential.
And now for our mission statement.
Unity Church of Sun Lakes is a spiritual community of love and light that is dedicated to the expansion of our divinity as taught by Jesus Christ and other master teachers. We commit our time, talents, and tithes to inspire more love and peace in our world.
Thank you, God. All right, we're going to welcome our new guests today. Do we have any new guests? Any old guests?
Any old guests.
Old guests, yes. We're going to welcome all of you. We're going to say our welcoming phrase for you. We love you,
we bless you, and we welcome you.
One thing, I like that song, what we could be proud of. There's a lot of things I was proud of this morning already. One is making it to church, so everybody's on that one. Yeah. Right? Right, good. And I just wanted you to know, I'm going to get into this prayer. It's called I Let Go of My Burdens. And God told me that our job is to be happy. So I wanted to share that with you, in case you didn't already know that. And this prayer will help you get to that place. All right. Cast thy burden upon the Lord, and he shall sustain these. Psalm 55:22. I let go of the burden that seemed to be mine to carry. Of myself, I was helpless to carry it. It was much too heavy, a futile struggle for my limited strength. As I cast it upon the Lord, the divine law of my being, I am immediately sustained, for I lay hold of infinite strength. The burden not only becomes light, but like the phantom thing it was, fades away altogether. As I recognize that the omnipotent strength of God Almighty is mine to use, the burdens cease to be burdens. Christ-centered, I can say with Jesus, my yoke is easy and my burden is light. As I turn trustingly to the Father within, who knows all of the answers business and is not limited by thoughts of time or space, ways or means, that which seemed impossible takes place easily. I am relieved that the backlog of unfinished business and fresh, new, creative thoughts lend wings to my endeavor. Thine, O Lord, is the greatness and the power and the glory and the victory. And so it is.
So
we're going to let go. And now we have Daily Word by the famous.
Okay, that's what I needed to do. The word for today is grace. I walk in grace and peace today. I give thanks for the activity of God in my life that appears as grace. This divine gift manifests as the beauty of the world and the people in it, and as the comforting peace, presence of God within and around me each day. I do not have to do anything to earn grace, because it does not result from my attitude or actions. It flows from the infinite love of God within every person and surrounding every circumstance. It is the indwelling presence that sustains me in challenging times and lifts me in good times. I accept grace with gratitude when I have stumbled along life's path and received unexpected blessings. This boundless love fills my heart with bliss and peace. I live in the presence of infinite love, believing each unfolding event in my life is leading me to my highest good. From the Bible, 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 9, my grace is sufficient for you. The three G's are grace, goodness, and gratitude.
And now the Unity Church with the Unity of Sun Lakes prayer together.
Unity Church of Sun Lakes is a beacon of love and light. We welcome all with open hearts and open hearts to express their divine potential. We come together in oneness, creating peace, health, and happiness in our church community and in the world. Divine order guides our church as it prospers and grows, providing healing, love, hope, and friendship to all. And so it is.
Another song from Jennifer Sheets, and then meditation by Tom Rottweiler. You'll be after those songs.
The meditation today. The meditation today will be on objects and creating oneness. And if everybody has filled out form, filled out a little piece of paper, they're in this plate. And for those who didn't, it really doesn't matter that much. I have a couple blank pages up here right now. They'll be up here in the plate. I like to have a seamless meditation, so I'll be getting the meditation right at the end of the song. So just wanted to give you a little heads up what we're going to be doing.
Still can give me the wisdom to
Recall the words of the song we heard last week by Willie Nelson. Energy follows thought. Think of that. You've all put energy into these thoughts that are written down on these slips of paper. They represent objects that are sacred to your heart. In your mind's eye, close your eyes. Take a deep breath. Read the energy of the earth and the atmosphere coming into your lungs and departing and being very peaceful. You become one with the earth by doing this. Picture in your mind's eye a gray slate with the number 20 on it. 20 is a sacred symbol. Icosahedron, 20-sided special object itself. I'm going to picture the number 19. Each time you picture a new number, you go deeper and deeper into the silence. 18, 17, 16. Each time you go deeper, the gray turns into a lighter shade of blue. 15, 14, 13. As you go deeper into the silence, the bluer becomes more real. 12, 11, 10, 9. The bluer is getting bluer and bluer. 8, 7, 6. You're in a deep state of relaxation. You're going to think about the object that you put in the bowl. It represents something important in your life. All your aspirations are maybe in this object. 5, 4, 3. You're in the deep space of silence now. 2, 1. Remain in this space for a while. Contemplate your object. Energy follows thought. This plate with all the objects on it, the thoughts of these objects, the pieces of paper, glowing with energy, commingling energy, creating a oneness. This oneness comes a strength. return to now. Return to this space in this room. Return knowing that you've gotten strength that you didn't have before. To carry on with your life. Open your eyes when you're ready and be at peace.
Thank you, Tom. That was lovely. And now before the Reverend Sparkle comes up and says a few words, Jennifer will sing another song.
By special request, this is a song I'm sure some of you will recognize, and I invite you to please sing along.
How many of you remember that song?
Yeah.
Oh, yes. It was such a great song. It was originally performed by the Fifth Dimension, and they won 4 Grammys, including Song of the Year. And guess what year?
71.
No.
67.
Yeah. And I think it's a beautiful song even today. It applies. Thank you for doing the lyrics on that too. So I asked for this song to be sung today because it's perfect for what we're talking about and what we're going to do today. We're going to go up, up, and away. And we've done this the past 3 weeks, and we're going to do more of it today. So, and then we're going to send it all away. What? We're going to send away what doesn't serve us anymore. So, we're going to do that later. And then we will truly be able to soar in our beautiful, beautiful balloon.
And we did that actually.
You did it?
Yeah, in Turkey.
Nice. And then the dreams that are on our hearts, big, little, or small ones, or anywhere in between, can become real in our lives. So the lyrics to the song said, love is waiting there in my beautiful balloon. Way up in the air in my beautiful balloon. If you'll hold my hand, we'll chase your dream across the sky, for we can fly up, up and away in my beautiful balloon. To bring everyone here on the same page this month, we are exploring the idea that before we go out into the world, into our doingness, we go in and we go up and anchor ourselves in source and in that divine wisdom, freedom, love, joy, peace, and abundance of source that lives within all of us. In the past 3 weeks, we've explored the hero's journey. Oh my gosh, Ela, wasn't she fabulous?
Oh, yeah.
Fabulous, yes. And then we have seven concepts, which we call the seven ups. So I have a big challenge for you this morning. Who can name all seven? Look up.
Make it up.
Give it up.
Give it up.
Lighten up.
Lighten up.
Kick it up.
Kick it up. Give it up. And start it up. So review. Look up to God, the source of all good. Lift up. Oh, we didn't say lift up, did we? Lift up. The vibration of our emotions by choosing a different thought. Lighten up. Lighten up. Don't take things so serious. Make it up. Decide our future and what our past meant. Give it up. Express our divine nature by being kingly givers. Being generous. Kick it up. Bring enthusiasm and passion to life. And start it up. Always start anything by going first within and receiving guidance. So today we're going to go up and up by taking a deeper look at two of those seven ups, and then we will send away that which might be blocking our ability to truly live from the up, up place. Is that okay? You with me?
Yeah.
Okay. So as we said already, look up refers to realizing that God is the source, the one and only source of all that is and ever will be. Now I know that there really is no up to look to. There's no up, there's no down, there's in front of or about in God. So looking up is symbolic. We all can relate to this. Oh, God. We always look up. But we look up metaphorically. God is the source, the substance of all supply. God, who is the creative impulse, the creative process, and the creation itself. Paul Hasselbeck, our modern day author in Unity, describes God by looking at the creative process, or what we call the law aspect of God. He calls it principle. The principle of all good. And sometimes this can feel really impersonal. We like to personalize God, don't we? We kind of all, maybe some of us grew up that God was a person up in the sky. And it's really hard to break that habit.
You know, but new authors in Unity are talking that God is principle, all good. But that's just one aspect of God. What does Charles Fillmore say? Can you imagine trying to attempt in writing to describe God? So this is what Charles Fillmore says. The starting point in spiritual realization is a right understanding of God. By describing God with words in our human way, we are but stating in the lisping syllables of the child that which in its maturity the mind still only faintly grasps. Gotta love Charles Fillmore. A lot of words. But I like it. You can only grasp God as a child. You're going to try to define. Words never express that which God is. Language is the limitation of mind. Don't expect the unlimited to leap forth into full expression through the limited. We must drop that complex and find simplicity before we can know God. So we must become as a child. He goes on to say, God's name represents wholeness. He is holy, perfect. God is being. You say, I am? That's a being. The creator, the infinite, the eternal, the ruler of the universe. Being is omnipresent. That means everywhere present. Omnipotent. All-powerful, omniscient, all-knowing. It is the fullness of God. God is the absolute, incomparable, omnipresent, all-good, the principle of divine benevolence that permeates the universe. Remember, we're talking about going up. So how can you bring this into your being? Being exists, Charles goes on to say, being exists under two phases, invisible and visible, abstract and concrete. The visible comes forth from the invisible. And this coming forth is always according to a universal method of growth. From center to circumference is the plan of procedure throughout the universe. And Ernest Holmes, creator of Science of Mind, describes God like this. Spirit is the Mother, Father, God, because it is the principle of unity. Back of all things, the masculine and the feminine principles both come from the one. Spirit is all life, truth, being, cause. Spirit is all. The center and the circumference of everything that exists, including you. Both manifest and unmanifest. It is undivided, complete, and perfect within itself. Having no opposite and no opposition. It is impossible for a finite mind to comprehend such a complete life and power. In moments of real inspiration, we realize, to a degree at least, that God is all. The life in everything, and the love through everything. The one presence and one infinite person, whom we call God or Spirit, within this one, all live. No separation. I don't know about you, but I felt it in Tom's meditation. I felt it right here in my heart that we were one. I felt that. I don't know if you did. No separation. We should be very careful in abstracting the principle, not to forget the essence. And it is to the essence, the source of all, and the complete power to which we can look up. This is what we do in the concentration step, which is the second step of our Unity five-step prayer process. We concentrate on all of these things I just said so that we get into that oneness before we go out into the world. We turn to that source and substance of all that is. We recognize it to the best of our ability. We feel its presence, and we align to the truth of our being. There is one power and one presence, one life, one creative energy, one essence, and that one is God. There are not two. There is not God and. There's only one. And the attributes and qualities of the one life are peace, power, love, joy, harmony, order, abundance, right action. And the human corollary to that is that this one and all the attributes of the one are found in each and every one of us, in each and every creation. That means us. The nature of God is good. It's love and wholeness, and it is available to us if we but allow it to be. I spent a lot of time this week in council about Israel and Gaza, and this conversation, it's in everyone. God is nearer than your hands and feet. In everyone. Nearer than your breath. Because God breathes as you. And if ever you need anything at any time, my friends, all you have to do is ask. And I promise you that the answer is close. And it is, in fact, inside. When people call for counsel, do you think I have the answers for them? I have the answers for me. All I do is listen for them and let them go inside. Just keep holding space and let them pull their answers. So listen to these words particularly if you are challenged right now, and deeply take in the idea that you truly can look up to Source at all times. And this is a poem by a lady named Barbara Blanson. She titled it, The Answers Inside. So you've made some mistakes and you're down on the floor. Well, brush yourself off. Try a different door. You can't lie there sulking. Get a hold of yourself. There's work to be done. There's dust on the shelf. If you will at least get up on your knees, just making the effort gets rid of the queasy. I hear this voice that is talking to me, but I don't see a thing. Tell me, who could it be? Then as I listen, I hear it again. I'm here with you and I am your friend. Can't you remember when you were small and you trusted me to not let you fall? Get up from the floor where you don't belong. Come on, grab hold and I'll help you along. Oh God, if there is one, I hear myself say. At the same time, I wonder, is this how I pray? Oh God, please hear me and help me to stand. As I reach up, I feel his strong hand. Why did I turn from your voice for such length until I gave up since I had no more strength? Why did I wait till I was in such despair before I remembered? You'll answer my prayer. There are so many lessons I've had to learn, but the most important is to know where to turn. When I felt all along like one pot on the shelf, if I could have remembered, you're inside myself. I'm never without you, though at times turned away. Every time I've listened, you've told me the way. So I'll keep my ears open to that one small voice. I'll pay close attention when I'm making a choice. I'll allow you to guide me and show me the way. I'll listen inside me and do as you say. I know if I listen and allow you to guide, I won't feel so frightened. I won't have to hide. Just knowing you're in me, your power and your strength renews all my courage and strengthens my faith. To know that you're with me when I go for a walk, to know that there's someone with whom I can talk, to look at the challenges of each new day in a totally different and loving way, turns all things around. Everything is so bright. It sure does help when you look up to the light. And when we come from that up space inside, we can then give it up. Because now we're full. Full, overflowing. Remember a couple of weeks ago, we said that in both definitions of grace and love, it refers to the givingness of spirit to its creation. If we truly want to express God at the highest level, then we too must begin from the inside and make a decision to be givers of life, or givers to life. We must choose to be kingly givers according to the Buddhist tradition. And in Luke chapter 6, verse 38, it says, "Give, and it shall be given unto you, good measure, pressed down, and shaken together, and running over. For with the same measure that you give with it, it shall be measured to you again." And 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verses 6 through 8, this is the King James Version. "He which soweth sparingly shall reap also sparingly, and he which soweth bountifully shall reap also bountifully. Every man according as he purposeth in his heart, so let him give, not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loveth a cheerful giver. And God is able to make all grace abound toward you, that ye, always having all sufficiency in all things, may abound to every good work. So now I have a video to share with you. And to me, this is one of the best lessons on give it up that I have ever seen. And it throws in a nice dose of lift it up as well. Into looking up, and by having an incredibly adorable lesson just given to us on giving it up. And we're going to bring our time together to a close with the third point for today, which is to send away whatever might be impeding our ability to go up and up. Okay, so if you will close your eyes with me and imagine yourself leaving the room and getting into your car and driving to an open field. It's a beautiful day. The sky is blue and clear with puffy white clouds scattered throughout. The weather's absolutely perfect and the field is filled with fragrant flowers. As you drive into this field, you notice there is a hot air balloon off in the distance, so you drive over to it. The balloon is fully filled with hot air. It is beautiful and colorful. It's also tethered to the ground with four strong ropes tied to stakes in the ground, so it isn't going anywhere anytime soon. You step out of your car, and right there, in between you and the balloon, is a big pile of whatever is impeding your ability to go up and up. It is perhaps unforgiveness of self or another, inaccurate self-image, guilt, shame, regret, a belief in lack, etc. Whatever it is, get an image of it right there between you and that balloon, and then pick it up. No matter how big or yucky it is, you can pick it up and not get any of it on you. And place it in that basket of the balloon. And again, no matter how big or unwieldy it is, it fits in the basket of the balloon. Now walk over to that first tether and untie it. Then walk to the one opposite the first and untie it. Walk to the third tether and untie it. Although it is a little difficult because there's a lot of resistance against it, the balloon wants to go up, up, and away. With a little extra effort, you get it untied and you walk over to that fourth and final tether. This one's really the hard one to untie, but you do get it undone, and the balloon lifts up, 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 higher, higher, higher. You stand, watch it, beginning to have that crane to your neck to see it. The wind then picks up and blows the balloon not only up but out. So now it starts moving away from you. It's getting smaller and smaller as it continues to go up, up, and away. Pretty soon it's just a speck in the sky. And then you blink, and when you reopen your eyes, it is gone. Take a deep breath and realize what has stopped you from truly experiencing the divine wisdom, freedom, love, joy, peace, and abundance of source that lives within you is now gone. Gone away. So just stand there and revel in the idea that with this impediment gone, you can be who you came here to be. God in expression, the great I am.
Andrew and Jeanne, you are incredible. That was a great, great sermon. I love that. Lots of different parts to it. It was great. Thank you. Let's say our monthly affirmation. I consciously choose to turn within and go up to the source of divine wisdom, freedom, love, joy, peace, and abundance before moving out into the world. Good idea. All right, first we will, as we start passing the giving bags, are you going to sing a giving song?
I will.
All right. All right, first we'll say the offering blessing. You ready?
Divine love, as me, blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I have, and all that I circulate. I am so blessed. Thank you, God.
Jennifer's, I am so blessed.
Go ahead.
I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful for all that I have. I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful. I am so blessed.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you. All right. Now the offering gratitude.
We give thanks for these many blessings of today and know they are but a symbol of the inexhaustible substance of the universe. I give thanks that 10 times this much or more is now on its way to me and quickly manifests in perfect ways.
Gosh, we're at announcements already. I'm not ready to go yet. Okay, we've got our prayer partner today is Barbara Kelly. And appreciate your help, Barbara, and everyone who does participates in being a prayer partner. We discussed at the last board meeting that we might have a, we will have a instructional class on being a prayer partner, so that we can have more people join in on that, and so you'll feel comfortable with the way to do it. So we're gonna have that the first weekend in January, and it'll be at my home in, where do I live? Sunbird. That's right, Sunbird. So I'll get you that address later, but that will be, anybody can come and learn and participate so we can all, you know, participate in being a prayer partner. The prayer team meeting every Wednesday at 10 a.m. and Julia hosts that. Reiki share group every Tuesday, 9:30. You can talk to Barbara about that. And a metaphysical group every other Wednesday with Sheila Taylor. Next Sunday, we'll have Barb Horton
and Brian
Palmerino. And I have a question from the audience, Kate.
So, something that I'd like to share with the congregation. As you all should know, or I think you all know, that we tithe on our gross income each month. And that tithing then goes and is sent out to a deserving organization. And in the month of July, because of the 4th of July and the fact that a lot of dogs are afraid of the big booms and everything that happens, and so in July, we felt that it would be good, the board decided it would be good to support an animal-related nonprofit in the area. And I wanted to share with you the letter we got back. We got it back so much later because she lost the check, but that's another story. To the members of Unity Church of Sun Lakes, thank you so very much for the donation of $199 for the care of the animals that reside here at Desert Mountain Foster and Rescue. These funds will go towards food and veterinarian care, which is so crucial to their well-being. Your donation and support means very much to us and is so deeply appreciated. Thank you from the bottom of our hearts. Sincerely, Jennifer Washburn, founder of Desert Mountain. So I just wanted to share that with you. We do these things, and sometimes we don't hear back from the organization and people, but when we do, I wanted to share it with you.
Thank you. Okay, any other announcements? I just wanted to remind you that for the sign-up sheets in the back for the next couple months, sign up to help us with the service. And now we're going to say thank you to Jennifer Sheets, Derek, Julia, Reverend Jeannie.
You know, thank Tom because he's prepared this for quite a while.
He was on my list.
Well, it was up there.
Oh, no.
Tom,
right? Thank you, Tom. That was really nice. That was a great meditation. And with the music and everything, was really nice. So, thank you very much.
Jill.
Oh, thank you very much. Happy New Year. Oh, yes, Jeannie has an announcement. Would you like the mic?
No.
She doesn't even want the mic.
Our beloved Derek is going to be off for 2 weeks, ends in November. And so we need to have a volunteer perhaps to shadow what he does over here. I've called people to see if they could come and do the setup and the sound, and I don't have any takers right now. So if someone could volunteer perhaps and maybe shadow Derek for a couple of weeks, I will as well. Might need some help in those 2 weeks. It's which, the last, the third and the fourth?
Maybe the second and third.
Second and third of November.
Okay. Can you try Mark?
Yeah, I need to call Mark. Yeah. So
thank you. I just want to mention the sermon again. I just thought it was so great. I love this 7-up theme that you have. I like that in the first place. But then you reviewed all that, and then you had your talk, and then you had the poem, which was awesome, and then you had the video. Yeah. I mean, you had everything in this. It was just really, really, really good.
Don't forget.
You just keep getting better and better.
Video. Don't forget the fifth dimension.
The fifth dimension! 1967. All right. So, Jennifer, we got another song, and then we will have the prayer of protection. This is a great song.
I was keeping. Oh, please, always. You are always invited to sing along with me. I don't know how else you feel about that. I love it. So, yes, go ahead. We're ready.
Thank you.
And thank you for that accompaniment, Reverend Sechmo. All right, everybody, we'll rise for the prayer of protection. The light of God surrounds us. I am the light of God. The love of God enfolds us. I am the love of God. The power of God protects us. I am the power of God. The presence of God watches over us. I am the presence of God. Wherever I am, God is, and all is well. Have a great week. Thank you.